Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel KPS Tools and Technologies Tips. Hi, I'm Kalpreet Singh and today I'm going to show you the application deployment process by using SCCM. So before moving ahead to our SCCM server and to show you like how we can do that application deployment, let's just give you the introduction, like what is application deployment and what is the benefit of using this application deployment. So application deployment is basically after watching this video, you will be able to deploy any application from your environment to all the machines like Windows 10, 8 and 7. Right now, most of the machines are on Windows 10. So there's no problem in deploying that application. So now the next thing is like why we use the application deployment. So many people ask this question to me, like what is the use of application deployment? The main use of this application deployment is to overcome manual efforts, which we use in application deployment. So for example, if we deploy any application to 1,000 machines, if we do it manually, then it will take around 30 days at least. It's a just like a guess it is, or you can say, it's very minimum I have given here 30 days, but still you can take it as 30 days. And if we use SCCM for deploying application, then it will cover 1,000 machines in maximum 3 days. In some machine there are some issues, there could be some issues like inactive machines or some other problems. So that's why I have given 3 days, but ultimately, or you can say it cover that 1,000 machines in 1 day itself. So this is the main use of this application deployment. So let's go ahead and start application deployment on my test environment. Okay, so I logged into my SCCM server. So for that, I have to, for application deployment, I have to go to software library. And here you can see application management, and under application management, you can see applications. This is a new infra which I have just prepared. So I just want to show you this new application deployment. So firstly, we have to go ahead and create application. Here we have to give the path of the application. I've already downloaded the 7GB application, 32-bit and 64-bit, both versions. I'm using right now MSA application, but there are so many other options which you can use, like EXE and APK and so many virtualization application also you can push through this SCCM. And but main thing is that this MSI deployment is really easy by using this application deployment. I'll show you the benefit of using this MSI. So you can download this 7GB MSI from their website. So let's click next. Just created the application. Here we have to give some detail. Here it's a 7GB software version is 19. And here we can mention it's a 64-bit. Or okay, so this is the main benefit actually. So if you see this, it has already picked this command line, which is good for this for our application deployment, because most of the time you see that you will not be able to find the command for any deployment, but if you use MSI, then it will automatically pick the command line. So we will click next, and the application this deployment type has been created. But before deploy, let me show you some features as well of this deployment type, which are really important. First one is a simple like the name and the version. Second one is related to the where content location. You can see here this content location of this software. Then third one is our command line, as we have already given. It has already picked the uninstall command line by using the product code. And also we can give the repair command line for that, so that if somehow it got crashed or some issues there, it should be automatically repaired by using this product code of the application. Now, as you can see, this this is main thing which you can see the previous version in 2007, this was not their detection method. And here this is really important in application deployment, and by using because of this detection method, our success rate is now very high. Because what happened in the previous version, application just install and uninstall automatically, like we have to do some manual efforts as well in previous version. But now in this newer version, what happened by using this detection method, it detect the application on the system. For example, if I have already installed the 7-zip, the same version, so what happened if I push this application to my machine, then it will not install that application, try to install that application again, because it's already installed. And it gives me that success that it's already installed on that machine. So it mark it as a success this machine. So other than that, this right now, it has already picked the product code, but there are some other options as well. We can use the file system and registry as well. So file system is basically we have to give the path, like if it's installed in our program file, so we have to give that same path. So next time what happen, it will try to search in our program file. If it's able to, if we are this detection method able to find that file in our system, then it will not go ahead with the installation and come back and give the success. And the third one is our registry. Same like file system, we have to give the registry path, like uninstall string or anything we can give from the registry, so that it can try to pick it from the registry, and if it's able to get that, then it can come back. So this is really important, and it's mandatory. We have to give out of three, one, there are three file system or registry and product code. So there are three options, we have to choose one of them, and then only we can go ahead. Then the next one is our how it should go to the end user. Like we have to always select this install for system, because and this one, whether or not user is logged in. So that, because so many times we have seen that if user is logged on, and if we select this another option, that only when user is logged on, then the success rate is very low. Maximum machines will be on pending status, because user mostly just lock the screen and go back to their home. So always try to use this option. If there is any mandate, like some applications are like require a user intervention. So for those application only, just select this install for user, and only when user log in. So here we can give the maximum allowed time. I'll give 20 minutes, and run time you can give, it's installed in 1 or 2 minutes, so I can give 2 minutes here, and this is related to the exit code. Then this is also most important part requirement. So for example, we want to deploy it on to the 64-bit machines. So what we can do here, we have to select here operating system, and here we have to give the because it's a 64-bit, so we will select all the 64-bit OS here, so that it should not go to the 32-bit machines, and unnecessary there is there could be failure. So like this, we can set the requirements as well in this deployment type. Then these are the return codes. For success, it's 0, and for hard reboot, it's 1641. 1618 is a fast retry. These are the some codes which, if you are able to see, then you can see that you can say that it's a success for you. And there is no dependency, so I'm not going to add any other application. So for example, for any other application, if we are going to deploy and that application has any dependency, for example, for office deployment, if we require the .NET framework, so we can add the .NET framework application here under dependency. So what happened in this, when we push that office package to the end user, firstly it will install that .NET framework, and then it can go ahead with the office application deployment. So like this, you can set the dependencies here, and after all these settings, we can go ahead and save it. Similarly, for 32-bit also, we can create a deployment type and deploy it. So the last step is we have to deploy this application. So let's go ahead with the deployment part. This is the software, and we have to deploy it on device collection. I have created one collection, that is test collection. Click next. Here we have to give the distribution point because I'm not distributed this application. It's a small application, so it will not take time to distribute. Here we can give the purpose of this installation. So if we give it available, so what happened, it will not forcefully install on your system. So we can see that it's there on the user system. It's like it depends on the user. If he require that application, then he can install, otherwise he can ignore that. But if we select it as a required, then it will automatically install on the system. So we will just put it as available so that it should not go to all the users forcefully. We can give the timeline, so we don't require that timeline to set because we want to push this application now. So this is the best, like we want to display in Software Center, and we just we can ignore these steps and click next, and application deployment is started now. So now we can go to the end user machine. And this is my end user machine. So firstly we have to check if we are able to see any application. No, not yet. So what we can do, we can go to our control panel, configuration manager, and here we can check actions. We can run this action manually. So by default, in every 60 seconds, client communicate with the management point and takes the policies. But right now, because we need to deploy it on priority, so we have to run these different, actually three cycles: application deployment, machine policy retrieval, and user policy retrieval. So once we run that, we can check in the logs. So we'll open, I think. You can check in the C drive, Windows, SCCM, logs, and firstly, it should come here under discovery. You should see this application. Yes, it's, you can see it's 7-zip came here. Yeah. Now you can see that this application is available under our Software Center under application category. So because we have selected it as a available, so right now it's giving us option that we want to install it or not. So we can install it by clicking. So once we click here, we can see the process in this log, app enforce.log. So as you can see that it's completed successfully with exit code 0. So in the application center also, successfully installed, and here it's also giving us uninstall option as well because we have given that command, uninstall command. So this is the whole process of installing and deploying that application on the end user system. So hope you have liked my this video. Please like, share, and comment, and also subscribe my channel if you want some more informative video on that. So thank you for watching my video. Thank you so much.